So students, today we'll discuss a little bit about the writing skills and the speaking skills as it has been discussed or told by CBSC for your examination, right? Now you're going to wonder that we are going to have writing skills and your paper is objective. So how are you going to get questions which are related to writing? So maybe that's a big question for you all, isn't it? Right? So let us just, before I start off here, naturally, you need to have an idea. You should be able to identify the writing skill. Only then you'll be able to do the questions related to it. Raghav, how are you? Feeling better? Are you? Yes? What about Shivansh? All well? Yeah? Okay, right. So two writing skills you have, right? One is your paragraph writing. And you have your letter. Our focus is on letter of complaint, business and official, and letter to the editor about general topics. Isn't this these kinds of letters we are going to do? Yes, Amritpal, we know all is well for you. It is good that you are well. Now, when we do write about a paragraph here, so when it is a discursive paragraph or a discussion on any topic, you know, like, so let us do the most common topic nowadays, right? Yes, so we can say that online teaching savior during the pandemic, or, right? Can anybody tell me what is the format of the paragraph that we have, right? Yes, what is the format of paragraph writing? You give the heading. I've given you the heading. And then you give your content, right? So, of course, there's an opening sentence. You have the content which has to be related and relevant. Yes. And of course, we give a conclusion, right? Just winding up the whole thing. And one thing here, what's wrong with the board? Is it clear now? It was blurred only? Maybe we need to clean the camera? It's because of the network connection, is it? Okay. It's still not, okay, then you listen to me. Listen to me then, that is the best option to do, okay? Improve your listening skills, right? Okay, not that much extent, never mind. Should I write big words now? What I have written is that I've given you a paragraph. All of you come and take out your notebooks, lazy people. And at home also, just turn in your videos and show me that you are writing. Come on. Right, now you have to get out of your lazy mode. Online mean does not mean, yes, Amritpal, thank you so much. And God bless you for being so obedient. Right? Yeah. Shantanu is also showing his notebook. Ma'am, I'm also obedient. Everybody is obedient. We're all good children, aren't we? Okay, online teaching savior during the pandemic. Savior, what does savior mean? To save us, isn't it, right? And how did online teaching become a savior during the pandemic? Can we think of points that we can write for this? Can you come on, you tell me the content. Give me ideas. What can we write over here? Yes? Yes, so offline teaching, we could not connect. We could not see each other. We could not meet each other. But because of online, we were constantly in touch, right? So yeah, that is the biggest, you can start, right? Yes, so right, we did not save the year, yes? Now, when I start with the paragraph writing, let us focus on the opening line. Online teaching a savior during the pandemic. When did online teaching become so popular? during the pandemic, isn't it, right? Before that it was there, but we heard of online, as in, you know, like maybe your online banking or online shopping, isn't it, right? Or you had, yes, your conferences and everything like that, but it became very, very popular during the pandemic. So we can start here, yes, with online teaching. It became very popular, or it was, you can say, the life saving option during the pandemic. And of course, yes, the students, they were able to see the teacher, interact with the teacher and even with the classmates through the online platform. What platforms have been used for teaching? What online platforms are there? So we have Zoom, yes. We have Google Meet also. We have Cisco and all, right? Yes, from Skype also teaching takes place, is it? Yes, Skype also teaching happens. Right. So the different mediums have been there, different platforms have been there, right? And of course here, what do you think? Yes, online is there, you know, like naturally, maybe during online teaching, we are constantly in touch, right? And we have access maybe to more information. Like you have your screen sharing, your video sharing, you have your online quizzes also, you have other you know, like devices or tools which are there, which makes your teaching much more and learning also more interesting and effective. Okay, right. Now, if I ask you a question right here for your writing skills, so I would say, what is the sequence of contents in a paragraph or in paragraph writing? Okay, what can be the options? Let's write down. I can write down, yes, relevant content. And you can say an interesting or conclusion, right? Then I can say it is, yep, informative opening lines. Opening lines, or you can say the introduction. Wait. Then I can say coherence of ideas. I have given these four options. Are you noting them down? Can you see? Well, you then listen. Okay, right. We have a little bit of problem if it is there. Now I can give, say, A can be. Okay, let me write. It can be 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. B option, first of all, let's see, B is 3. Okay, 2 and 4. 4 is, you know, like we have a kind of a relevant thing which is given just to confuse you all, isn't it? Right? So one answer is like that. Okay, then I can do it like 4, 1, 2, 3. Same to me, I get options. Then I can give here 1, 4, 3, and 2. Okay. So I have given you these four. You have to identify the correct sequence. Right? So which is the correct? 1, 4, 3, 2. Coherence of ideas. Coherence means connectivity. ये पहले होना चाहिए. ये is it a sequence or is it an important quality of the paragraph? It's quality of the paragraph. If you have to write the paragraph here, where will the coherence of ideas fit? पहले ideas सोचेंगे. ठीक है. Okay, fine. Right. So this is just a rough idea. Okay. Options कौन सी match होगी? कोई भी नहीं हो रही है? ओ, क्यों? बी बी वाला थर्ड इंफॉर्मेटिव रेलेवेंट कंटेंट कंक्लूजन कोहेरेंस ऑफ आइडियाज. वेट हियर, वी विल जस्ट चेंज इट अ लिटिल बिट. ओके एंड वील कंटिन्यूटी ऑफ कंटेंट. अब बताओ सर. नाउ टेल मी थ्री ऑप्शन. रेलिवेंट कंटेंट भी ठीक हो गया. चलो लेट अस मेक इट थ्री ऑप्शंस ओनली. ओके वन टू थ्री. अब मैं जरा इनको चेंज कर देती हूँ ऑप्शन. व्हाट इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन? इट इज फाइंड. इट इज टू थ्री वन. ओके सो ए की मैंने ऑप्शन दी है. वी जस्ट फाइंडिंग आउट द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. ओके right now if I have to come on and let us give three or four sentences about online teaching. Yes, Shantanu, give me the introduction. Give me the introduction. Online teaching is very important. Okay, let us write down. Is or you can say online teaching was a life saver. Yeah. Now, Jasleen, give me one more sentence here. Let us extend this sentence. Give me one more. Another one you can write. Yes. Okay. So different. Platforms are available. Yes. Okay. And it will continue after pandemic, isn't it also? Of course it would be. We will have that hybrid version. And somebody else said, what did you say right now? Okay, saved a year. Saved a year. I have to write these sentences. Yes, absolutely, Mani, correct. I have to write these sentences in sequence now. Right? I'll give you the options then. Okay, you people are so lazy. You find the options. Come on, you write your option. Write your own sequence. Write your correct sequence. What would be the correct sequence? Write it down. नहीं तो coherence क्या होता है? Coherence में ये होता है कि ये नहीं कि जब याद आए कोई sentence you wake up and write anything. If you are talking about online teaching, right? What is the importance of it? What platforms were used? How it helped the students? Right? Okay. Fine. Which of these could be an opening line? First one could be an opening line. Okay, so fine. Then what could be a continuation? Okay, it was a lifesaver or it saved a year. Okay. Then we have third. Okay, and then this would be codes. Fine. Is it right? Generally, this should be the correct sequence. Okay. Fine. Huh? ऐसे ही आएंगे. Writing skills are going to be like this. Fine. Yeah. But of course, here because I'm just thinking of it instantaneously. So when I'm going to make the paper, I will take time and think of something difficult for you all. And then I will make the question. Isn't it? I'm not going to make it so easy for you. Okay, right. If I say, now one more question. What is the sequence? Let's rub this one. And I can ask a question like, what are the important components. Write down, please. These are the only questions available. I don't think so. We have sample papers right now. So I am your question bank right now. Okay. What are the importance components of a paragraph? Okay. Right. So one is, coherent. Where are the chalks? Coherent ideas. Okay, give me chalks in. I write date and time. No, you're not going out anywhere. Sit down. Or obviously, right? So this is correct. Yeah. Okay, fine. Now, if I say here, write down what is an important component in letter of complaint. What is an important component of letter of complaint? You can hear me, no? Then you can write down what is an important component of the letter of complaint. Okay. I can add a reference letter. Is there? Right. One and third. Yes. So what are the important components of a, what is a reference letter? What is a reference letter? Yes. What is a reference letter? What is a reference letter? Your reference ID, or you can see here that when it was purchased and all. I've given date of purchased also. I've given the nature of complaint. Okay. Right. So you can identify. Yes. So, right. Date of purchase, nature. Otherwise, date of purchase is also important. But because I've given the option here, then you think, no, three are important. Then you have another option. All of the above. So all of the above, mein to one and three bhi aa jayega. Because you don't want to miss out one. So you'll have to take the correct option. Okay. So some options are there which are like, yes, in which we tell about ourselves. What do we tell about ourselves in the reference letter? Yes, absolutely. You tell about reference letter is when I bought that. You have an ID, a memo, bill number. Ya tumne pehle koi correspondence kiya tha. You told them right away that I've purchased this. I want to buy this. That is your reference letter. You have your cash memo ID. That is the reference ID. Okay. Clear? Is this clear? A little bit of idea you have about now what kind of questions you can get. Right? Now let us get ideas here for another paragraph. This is again, once again, I'm going to write down upon an idea which you have, you know, like, of course, Yes, come on, let us have a good. Yeah, all of the above is the last answer, is the correct one. Yes, because when you look at 1 and 3, you miss out 2 also because you want to mention the date of purchase also. Then you realize it has to be all of them. Okay, right. Yes. So some idea, you've got some kind of questions which you will get. Okay. So as and when I am able to get more questions, I'll be sharing with you. So we'll I'll share that PDF with you all regarding that. Fine. Now let us come on. Let me have sentences. Yes, Vansh. You Vansh, no? Yeah. Can you give a few lines about importance of mobile phones in our life? Let's have a good opening line. Okay. You want to speak, Jaya? Yes. Okay. It is. For to remain connected. Yes. What else? Yes. So of course it is there helps us in our online classes. Big question mark. Where do the other people go then? When online classes are going on, I have 32 plus 9, 41. Where are 7 students missing? With their mobile phone. They've gone away. Okay, what else is impact? So it is pros as well as cons also, right? We have the positives as well as the negative. So positive, yeah, we're always connected. We have, you know, like we're teaching or learning and you are always able to get new information. Yes? So of course, it's life is unimaginable without it. Then, what else? Living a fantasy life. So when we talk about phones, we talk about social media also. Yes. So of course, we can say there are a lot of distractions. There are distractions also. What are the distractions? You have your social media and other apps or your games or whatever. Because we're talking about impact, we can talk about positives as well as negatives. Can we have a few negatives now? Yes? Eyesight. Okay. What about eyesight week? Yes? Yes, of course. It's a bad influence also in the long run, you know. We are not, we can say there's no control at times there over the kind of, maybe the content that you watch, isn't it? Right? So of course, the parents can't be there watching you all the time. So of course, you are there responsible for the kind of content you watch. Then sometimes, what about say here, when you are with the phone here, when we talk about internet, we also talk about, what are cyber crimes and all? Right, you have your hacking and stalking. Let us talk about things that affect you all. Isn't it? Some links are there. You accidentally click a link, right? Yes, yeah, so you have stalking is there. What is stalking? What is stalking? Yeah, to like, yeah, like you say here in the real world, you say it is following someone. So of course, you're stalking also, you really, your celebrity is there online and a social media account and you want to know everything about that person. Isn't it? Right? Then of course, yeah, is it right or is it wrong stalking someone? So if you're doing it in a positive way as a fan, as a follower, good enough. But if you're doing it with the intention of hurting that person, then it is wrong. Right? So when we talk about stalking, we also end up here. Yes, sometimes we are becoming victims of, because we come across many people, you know, they don't put up their own profile pics and all, and they are there, you know, like maybe sending messages to children also. You might be a victim of some kind of, you know, like cyber crime, isn't it? So it is always very, very important to be cautious, okay? So of course, you have the mobile phone in your hand and you need not to be with it always. You need to put it away. So we should limit the time that we use about. Can we have a conclusion for this? Someone give me a conclusion. Someone give me a conclusion. Can you give me a conclusion? Oh my God, that is the easiest conclusion. So of course, it is entirely up to us that we should use it in a wise and judicious manner, right? So except of everything is bad. So exposure to the mobile phone for a long time, it will result in loss of, or you can say weakness of eyesight. It will, your weak loss of concentration, isn't it? You will become lazy. You don't want to go outside. It will affect your health also, right? So it is there, and it disturbs your sleep pattern also. Have you noticed? So before going to bed, if you are there with a mobile phone, do you think you're able to, of course, concentrate? Or you have to, you're able to have a sound sleep? No, right? So it does cause a lot of distraction, okay? But remember here, I can give you paragraph writing as homework. No one can stop me from doing that. So what if we're having multiple choice questions? We need to practice, because at the end of the day, your final exam is going to be what? Subjective also, isn't it? You're going to have mixed kinds of questions here. So write, so you need to practice writing. So we are going to focus on this, because for English, if you do not practice your writing skill, it's a big loss. It's a big loss. Okay, right? So we'll end up over here. Yeah, posture becomes bad. Very nice.